Hi, this is Dr. Isha and welcome to my YouTube channel. Yes, these are tiring times. Yes, every profession is affected. But the worst affected profession is the dentistry. Because everywhere we are heading, you should prefer social distancing, you should wear masks. Dentists have to make you sit in his chair. Where is social distancing gone? He has to remove up your mask and work inside your oral cavity. And that is his profession and he has to do that. So what he needs to do, he needs to follow basic protocol so as to relieve himself from that stress hormone that is cortisol. Research has been carried out on the dental professionals of America where the cortisol levels of the dentists, they have shot up like anything. So as to make yourself positive in such a situation, there is a basic protocol which needs to be followed and you have to follow that protocol. Avoid overlapping appointments, then you have to say no escorts along with the patient. Only the patient has to be allowed inside your clinic. Your waiting chamber should not have so many of items because each item can act as depositor of aerosol because aerosol generation is going to happen in the dental procedures. Then in case the patient arrives, you have to take a thorough history of the patient. His fever has to be checked up. Coughing symptoms or any respiratory distress is there, that has to be seen. Then you have to have a consent form signed by the patient in which he confesses that he doesn't have any of these symptoms while he entered your clinic. This is very much required for that legal, so that you are legally safe. That is very much required. Then in case the doctor, then for the doctors, we all know that you have to have, every one of you might be knowing, you have to have PP kits, then you have to have face shields, eye layers, you have to have triple layered masks, there should be there, your hat caps have to be there, then your shoe covers have to be there, everyone knows that. Once the patient arrives and you have to do that dental procedure, just remember once that the time period of exposure to that patient should not be more than 10 minutes. Each and every sitting should not be more than 10 minutes because if the exposure is less than 10 minutes, then your chances of carrying that infection from the patient, they are very mild. In case the patient is positive, then also the symptoms become mild. So multiple sittings should be given and the time period of exposure should be less in patients. What are procedures you can't be doing? If you avoid using ultrasonic scalers, you can use hand-operated scalers, which were used many times back. And then you can use low-speed micro motors because aerosol generation will be less. Then do use rubber dams as much as possible and give a pre-procedural mouth rinse with hydrogen peroxide 1% and 0.1% or 0.1% povidone iodine solution. It also helps in decreasing the microbial load inside the mouth. Then you also have to provide the head glare and everything to that patient also, which you also might be knowing. Then use of three-way syringes should be minimum. Use of water sprays should be minimum. Then X-rays should be avoided. X-rays, why they should be avoided? Because sometimes they produce a gag and the patient might cough and sneeze. And then, a single cough or sneeze will fill up your whole apartment or fill your whole dental wing with the aerosols. Then another thing is you should see that the ventilation of your chamber should be very proper. In case the ventilation is not proper, you should buy up. There are certain things like air exchangers are available. In any case, air should be exchanged. Air exchangers are available and then for the evacuation also, there are many new, in case you want to invest in these type of machineries, you can invest in these type of extra oral suction materials are there. You can invest in those type of things also. In case you don't want to invest right now, then a simple thing is all of you have an electric kettle and camphor tablets are available everywhere. These just fill up your electric kettle with water and switch it on and put a camphor tablet. All throughout 2 or 3 hours of your procedures, you have to switch it on the electric kettle so that the fumes of that camphor should fill up your dental chamber because they have very good antiviral properties. You can search the internet for that. Good antiviral properties, antifungal properties, antibacterial properties. They are very good. And whenever you are free from the patient and you see that there are no more patients, you can just inhale that, you can do that steam inhalation from that kettle also. So just switch it on throughout that time. Then after that, you can also, then there are certain few herbs which you should take regularly, and they are ashwagandha, giloy, tulsi. All these three herbs, they are very nice. They don't allow the infection to spread. The virus, they cannot replicate. The giloy doesn't allows the replication of the virus. You can go through my previous videos to find out what is the action of giloy, what is the action of ashwagandha, and what is the action of tulsi. So all these are protective measures. Along with the PP kits and everything, you have to put inside your body certain few things which can boost up your immune system, and these are these drugs which will help you. And anyone can take these herbs, because these are not going to have any side effects in your body. So you have to protect by taking these herbs regularly, because you have to protect your family, because you are responsible for your family. You are exposing your family. You are going every day to your family also, and you have to work in these in this environment also. You can't withdraw yourself from this profession, and you can also not throw any carelessness. So you can invest that, and moreover, throughout the day, you should have that water mixed with herbs, warm water mixed with herbs like cinnamon, like haldi, like you can take turmeric milk also. All these things also you have to take regularly. Along with that, in your chamber also, whatever investments you want to make, in case you want to make investments, you can buy air exchangers and extra oral suctions. In case you don't want to make investments right now, you can just buy an electric kettle and do the procedure which I have told you. So in any case, whenever you will follow all these protocols, after that you leave everything to God, because He's the supreme power, and you have to work in a very positive attitude, because that positive attitude will not let your cortisol levels boost up. And those cortisol or stress hormone levels, what in research it has come that those people who have contacted, who are positive with this virus, and in case their cortisol levels are very high, they are not recovering. And those people whose cortisol levels are down and they are positive, they are showing so much of good recovery. So in any case, that cortisol levels should be down, and that can only be down if you are following this protocol. Thank you so much for watching. In case you like this video, just like, share and subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much for watching.